Hey guys, Robbie here from CrossFit South Bend. Today we are going to talk about the 7-day carb test. Now, I have to give credit where credit is due here. Robb Wolf, very famous nutrition expert in sort of the field of paleo and ancestral nutrition, recently wrote a book called Wired to Eat. It's a fantastic book. If you don't already have it, go out and get it. I've read it twice already. Robb Wolf is one of my personal heroes in the health and wellness space. And one of the really cool things he talks about in there is something called the 7-day carb test. And I think this can be a really fantastic way for people as individuals to determine their individual level of carb tolerance depending on the carb that they're consuming. So what's the 7-day carb test? Well, essentially, there have been studies that have shown that people react very differently to certain types of carbohydrates depending on the individual. So while it's true that almost everyone is going to have a way higher blood sugar spike when eating a cookie than when eating celery, for example, it's not always the case that when you get to, you know, same higher carb things like, say, a cookie and a potato, that everyone's going to have the same blood sugar spike. In fact, one of the most interesting findings of these studies is that people can actually have a lower blood sugar spike with a cookie than with a white potato or white rice, for example. Or someone could have a way higher blood sugar spike with beans than with white rice, for example. But then someone else could have the exact opposite reaction to those very same foods. And the point of this all wasn't to say that eating a cookie is healthy if it gives you less of a blood sugar spike. There are lots of other reasons not to eat a cookie from a health perspective, but it's to say that one's tolerance for carbs is very, very, very individual. And what you can glean from this is you can find out that certain carbs might be better for you and lead to a healthy blood sugar response long term as opposed to other carbs. So for example, you know, if you just know, man, I feel really lightheaded or weird after having white potatoes, but I feel fine with sweet potatoes, that could be you intuitively knowing something that could be demonstrated with a blood glucose monitor showing that your blood sugar spikes really high after eating white potatoes, but not so much after eating sweet potatoes. So what is the 7-day carb test with all of that background information in mind? The 7-day carb test is basically where you buy a blood glucometer, and I've done other videos which I'll link to that explain you know, how you might use a blood glucometer. But basically what you do is over the course of 7 days, each morning you have a different type of carbohydrate source, whether that's, you know, and these are the ones that you really like and would eat a lot, so maybe 50 net effective carbohydrates of pineapple or white potatoes or sweet potatoes. And again, it really is worth buying Robb Wolf's book because he's got this all worked out for you. You can find it online as well, these values, but it's basically 50 net carbs from these different sources. It could be white rice, it could be you know, beans, what have you. And what you do is you take your blood sugar before you eat those foods, and then ideally 1 and 2 hours after. And if 1 hour after it's you know, higher than 140, then chances are it's something that you're not having a good blood glucose reaction to. You know, it could be 180 or something crazy like that. That would be really high. And if 2 hours after it isn't below 120 and ideally closer to fasting, then that could be something that you have blood sugar issues with. So this is a very nice thing where if you're okay with getting a blood glucose monitor from, you know, your local Walmart, you can get all the equipment for no more than 50 or 60 bucks. You don't need to spend a ton of money. You can actually find out, is a sweet potato giving you more issues than a white potato, or vice versa? Or is white rice okay for you to have occasionally? Or is that the thing that's throwing you off and making you feel, you know, spacey or lightheaded or giving you hypoglycemia reaction? So in that sense, it's very, very, very helpful. And then going forward, one of the things you can do is you can know, well, hey, let's say, for example, beans give you way more of a blood sugar spike than white rice, then beans are something you're going to save for maybe a special occasion, and white rice is something that you know that you could have on a more regular basis, maybe post-workout. But that's not something you'd really, you know, you'd really expect initially. Initially, you would think, well, of course the white rice is gonna spike my blood sugar more than the beans. That's what we would intuitively think for most people. And for a lot of people, that is the case, but not for everyone. And that's what's so interesting about this, is that you can really dial things in and find out what's right for you. So, to recap, if you don't already have Robb Wolf's book, Wired to Eat, go ahead and get it. It's awesome, it's fantastic. Once you have it, you can do the 7-day carb test where you can find out your individual level of carb tolerance. And this will tell you what you can safely have and what should maybe be avoided more long-term. And that will give you a really good way to optimize your health for you individually, rather than making this blanket statement that white rice is always bad for everyone, or beans or white potatoes. It really depends on the individual. All right, guys, thanks so much for tuning in. We'll see you next time.